press forward.
I mean, we've been working at this for 4 years. I mean, that's...
Yeah, it's true, we are press whores, but then again, you gotta be in this business, because...
That's the point. I mean, that was the whole point of coming to Park City in the first place, is that it's the only festival in America that gets this much of a concentration of press. And not just industry, but the press, and that's the point of being here.
And the counterpart in Europe is really Cannes, for Europe, and after 50 years, how many sidebars does Cannes have? 3, 4, 5 now?
Yeah.
They all grew out of protest. I get no town, but I get no town.
The first year, there were just a few of us, a solid core of filmmakers who were invited to join Dan Mirvish, Shane Coon, and John Fitzgerald in something they'd created called Slamdance. And I think what most of us had in common is that we were either rejected or unable to make a deadline for Sundance. And they had created Slamdance and invited, originally it was going to be held in Salt Lake City, but some of us got a car and a projector and a screen and just came up here and started showing our films. And so that's how Slamdance moved from Salt Lake City to Park City.
That because Sundance had an overwhelming success, which is a deserved success, that surprised everybody and still surprises everybody, in that it became such a focal point for U.S. independent cinema. This was a great surprise. And it was a little horrifying, particularly to Robert Redford, as he said many times publicly, because this success also brought a lot of notoriety, a lot of kind of craziness, a lot of media attention, and it was more than anyone knew how to handle, because it was so overwhelming. And what happened to Slamdance is Slamdance said, "Hey, we're here too. We're young. We're the outsiders. We want attention too." Well, they got that, and now what's happened is Slamdance has become part of that success. Drinks a whiskey drink. He drinks a vodka drink. He drinks a lager drink. He drinks a cider drink. He sings the songs that remind him of the good time. He sings the songs that remind him of the better time.
My distributor made the unfortunate mistake of announcing to the press the fact that we were in Sundance, and of course I got a very irate phone call from someone at Sundance basically going, "Nobody announces what's in Sundance except me," and therefore...
That was God calling.
That was God?
God calling?
I didn't know Jeff Gilmore was God.
Oh, that was Jeff Gilmore.
Is he God?
Well, no, he's the guy who rejects everything. No, God is the one who admits film.
Oh, right.
Nice. I see.
Anyway, I personally at that time thought that Jeff Gilmore was God.
Program. Largely the dartboard system.
No, programming. Well, it gets longer and bigger and more
violent
every year.
Yeah. It's tough. I mean, 1,300 films, 20 odd programmers, and some watch a lot more than others, less, and and the difficult thing is, unlike a Sundance or some of the other festivals, we're not professionals. None of the program. We're in a good way. We're not paid.
It's from the heart. It's the passion.
It's largely Slamdance alumni, who are unemployed. And which may say something about our alumni.
The other jurors, some are filmmakers, some are journalists. We haven't all met yet together. We haven't sat down and duked it out. But we've talked a little bit among ourselves, and I can see that there's going to be a process of identifying what the criteria we think are important in determining whatever the best film is. I already know that I'm not going to be determining the best film by whether it has distribution potential in the United States. And I think that's a big criteria now at some of the A-list festivals.
The deal with Slamdance, as far as I'm concerned, is the only festival where the films are still admitted on a merit basis. There's no way to get a film into Slamdance unless it's good. You can't pay anybody.
And you're a first-time filmmaker.
You can't bug your way in. You can't muscle your way in. Your distributor can't do jack shit. What do you think Dan Mirvish is going to give a damn about some phone call from some guy in Hollywood? There's no way. If it's good, it's gone. If it's bad, it won't be in. And that's the reason that this festival is so great. And all the filmmakers are are starting a career that's going to be great. I mean, a lot of talent shows up here. And that's why I think it's the most interesting festival of the year, really.
The festivals are very unique. Sundance has become kind of a big Hollywood. I think of it as like the distributors, Miramax, October, New Line. They've all kind of grown from really small, edgy films into the bigger budgets. And I feel like Sundance has kind of grown with them. And I feel like Slamdance is kind of now filling a void where Sundance used to have the really edgy films that maybe a little unpolished, the gems, so to speak, that need a little bit of shining. That's kind of what Slamdance is doing now. So people are getting a chance to see a little bit more cutting edge movies. And in Sundance, you're getting a chance to see something that will probably be at your local multiplex within the next couple of months.
The best thing about the way this festival is running right now, in my opinion, is that there's a lot of complaints that Sundance... To me, the size isn't the problem with Sundance. It's the kinds of films they're programming. They're programming films by people who are already established. If you look at their documentaries, they've got a Ken Burns film, they've got a Michael Moore film, they've got a film by Barbara Kopple, they've got a film by Allison Anders. I mean, these are people who've all got major distribution in the past. Slamdance, because its mission is devoted to discovering new talent and first-time filmmakers, will always have a niche. And people are going to have to come here if they want to see the best new talent, because it's not going to be down the hill.
Howdy. You know, I was talking to Robert Redford last week, and he told me, he said, come on out to the film festival, I'll get you a limo, a place to stay, a couple hookers, and you'll have a great time. And here I am, I'm having a great time, and he said I could show my film. Just kidding, Robert Redford would never say that. I get no time.
We've all had films and gone to other festivals, and we've learned what it is to be a filmmaker at a festival. And we know, you know, we can remember the fun ones, the good ones, where the good festivals were, who took care of us well, and we try to integrate a little bit of all of that into this festival.
You know, as someone who loves film, after watching a film, you can have a dialogue with the director, you can have a dialogue with the actors. It's that kind of intimate experience that it's really a nice way to look at filmmaking.
I used to work with Cannes. I went to Cannes for many years. And Sundance, I always said I would never go to Sundance until I had a film. And so I went with Hurricane Streets, and it was great because, you know, we won 3 of the 7 prizes. But the next year I went back with this very artsy, strange movie called Inside Out, which is it's a beautiful film, but it's not like a Sundance, you know, crowd pleaser. And it was always the Slamdance people that were having the most fun.